गुड मॉर्निंग एंड अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन स्टूडेंट्स. ओपन योर बुक पेज नंबर 6 ऑफ रीड नाउ बुक. एंड यस्टरडे वी हैव डन क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, 2 एंड 3. एंड टुडे वी विल कंप्लीट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. द किंग प्रॉमिस टू गिव अ गोल्ड पीस टू द बॉय. सो हाउ मेनी अदर टाइप्स ऑफ मैटर्स कैन यू नेम? सो द आंसर ऑफ ए पार्ट इज आयरन एंड सिल्वर. एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो नेम एनी अदर मैटर्स ऑल्सो. Okay students, the next question is, what is an ingot and a carat? So carat, it is a unit of weight for diamonds and other gemstones. And ingot, a block of steel, gold, silver or other metal. Okay, question number C, name two things which are made in carats. So their names are gemstones and pearls. Okay student, question number 5 is, we say one goose but say two geese. So it means we are talking about plurals. One thing is called singular and more than one things are called plurals. Okay student, what is singular and what is plural? I think you already know it, but just see these pencils. Okay, you can see this is single pencils and these are two pencils. So because it is only one pencil, so only one thing is called singular and more than one things are called plural. They can be two or they can be 3, 4, 5, 6 and more. Okay, so one thing is called singular and more than one things are called plural. So you can see this is singular and these are plurals. We will say it's pencil and we will say it pencils. We will add s with the plural. So students, what is answer of question number 5? Cow is one cow. And what is the plural of cow? Cows. And fox. Fox is one fox. And when there are more than one fox, we will say it foxes. We will add es. Okay. Sometime we add s and sometime we add es with the plurals. And sometimes, as I told you in the junior English page, that sometime we add ies also. Okay. When the last letter, you can see here, this is the last letter. If the last letter of any singular is y, you can see here y, we will cut the y and in place of y we will write ies. Okay, fly, flies. In the same way, wolf, if the last letter in singulars is f, we will convert f into ves. Okay, in place of f we will write v. So wolf is one wolf, and if there are more than one, so we will say it wolves. This is the plural, singular, and these are plurals. Mouse, there is one mouse, and when there are more than one mouse, we will say it mice. Okay students, in the same way you will write those words over here. Okay, so the next question is, the gander was the head of the flock. Give family name of gander, bull, Ram, Billy, Goat and Tom Cat. But before starting questions students, first of all I will tell you what is masculine and what is feminine. Masculine students, as you read in junior English book of class 2 of previous class, that masculine means he and feminine means she. Like boy, girl. Boy is he and girl is she. Okay, you already read it in previous class. Okay, first of all I will explain it. Masculine nouns are words for men that are used for men, boys and male animals. Okay, and what are feminine? In simple word you can say she. So feminine nouns are words for women, girls and female animals. Okay. Okay students, as there is very less space in book, so I paste an extra page. Okay, to complete it. So masculine and feminine, so as I told you that masculine mean he and feminine mean she. So gander, goose, bull, cow, ram, ewe, billy goat, she goat, tom cat, cat. Okay students, the next question is, give feminine of king, prince, brother, boy and uncle. Okay, so king, is he, this is the side of he and this is the side of she. So king, what is the feminine of king? Queen, prince, princess, brother, sister, boy, girl, and uncle, aunt. Okay, students, the next question is the geese, kegel, and haste. What sounds do these creatures make? Dog, cat, sheep, owl, donkey, wolf, lion, horse, frog, and cow. So again, I paste a sticky note because there is very, you can see there is very less space. Okay. So animals and their sounds. These are the names of animals and these are the sound, their sounds. Dog, the sound of dog is bark, cat, mew. Sheep, bleat, owl, hoot, donkey, prey, wolf, and the sound of wolf is howl. The sound of lion is roar, horse is knee, and the sound of frog is croak, and the sound of cow is moo. So these are the sounds of animals and you will learn it. It's a very important question. Okay, students, next question is the boy found the book but the king lost the case. What are the opposite of these words in the story? So land, loved, morning, hot, stopped, asleep, remembered, short, fast, and after. But first of all, we will see what is the definition of opposite. Okay, what are opposites? Okay, students, what is opposite? A person or thing that is totally different from someone or something else. Okay, that is called opposite. Okay, so students, you can see here the difference of this tree and this flower. This is very big and this is small. So a person or thing that is totally different from someone or something else. So they are totally different in their height or in their figure. So this is big and this is small. You can see the size of a tree and you can see the size of a flower. So this is called opposite, big, small. In the same way, you can see here there are two glasses of water and this is full of water and this glass is empty. So you can see the difference. Okay, they are totally different, full, and this is empty. Okay, students, so what is the opposite of land, sky, loved, hated? Because there is the second form of love, so we will use the second form of hate also, loved, hated. Morning, evening, hot, cold, stopped, started, here again ed, and we will add here also ed, stopped, second form, and we also write the second form of start, start, started, stop, stopped. Asleep, awake, remembered, forgotten. Okay, and short, long, fast, slow, after, and below. Students, if you are missing work, so complete this exercise of chapter number 1 and also learn this full exercise. Okay, take care, Allah Hafiz.